back to my channel. For today's video, I wanted to do some candle making. So I bought all the things that I need already, which are right here. So basically all you need is wax of some sort, a jar, maybe some fragrance oils, and the wick. To color them, you can also throw in like some crayons. I don't know about food coloring, how that works, but since crayons are wax already, you basically just a pigment from that and melted in will like do the job. The fragrance that I got is apple blossom. It smells so good. It smells fresh, like flowers. That's kind of like the smell that I like to get when I buy candles from the store. So I tried making candles as a gift for Christmas for my mom one time, and to be honest, it didn't really work out. That's because I rushed through it, but I did my research, I watched a few videos, I went to like 3 different craft stores to like buy all these things. So with that being said, let's get into it. For the first step, I'm gonna start taking my candle and I'm gonna kind of like breaking the wax up so they're in smaller chunks. So I have my bowl and I accidentally dropped this candle on the floor right now. So it's already cracked in a sense. So that was really easy. So I have the wax into chunks. I'm gonna put them into this pan. I'm gonna place it inside of this one. So now that I have my pot full of wax, I'm not sure if these chunks are too big or not, but we'll find out. While I let this boil, I'm gonna glue the wicks inside the mason jar. So all I'm really doing is taking the base of the wick, applying some glue, and before it dries, I'm quickly gonna apply it onto the jar. Now that it's in the jar, I'm just gonna use the end of this wooden spoon to like hold it down in place and make sure it stays there. I'm gonna let the glue sit for a second and then I'm gonna take a pencil and wrap the wick around it so it stands up straight and in place. Here you can see the wax is already starting to melt. What I'm gonna do is break up some more wax and throw it in there. I just took this crayon and I broke it and I'm gonna throw this little piece inside of the wax so it adds color to it. I'm gonna continue to stir the wax until it melts. And when it's done melting, I'm going to add the fragrance inside of it. So this one is pretty much set in place. I'm gonna take a pencil and just make sure that it stands in the place that I want it to. Just like that. Now that the wax is completely melted, I'm gonna let it sit for 1 minute and then I'm gonna go ahead and add the fragrance inside of it. Oh, it literally smells so good. I'm just gonna pour in the scent into here. And I'm gonna stir it again. The wax is ready to pour. I'm gonna just pour it in here. So I spilt it all over the counter, as you can see right here. I got it on the side of the jar, but I think I should have waited for it to kind of cool down a little more, but that's okay. We're gonna try again. But it kind of looks cute. Like, first of all, it looks like a little tropical drink. It smells really good, like from what I can smell from it not being like set yet. So I'm gonna start breaking up the wax and trying again. I decided to do this color of blue. I think it's super pretty. The scent that I'm using is apple blossom. So I feel like just to kind of like correlate the smell with the color, I feel like this would be really pretty while it's burning. I'm also gonna try to find a white crayon so I can make it in pastel color. While we wait for the remaining wax to melt, I'm gonna go ahead and throw in my two crayons that I chose and just let them melt inside of there. So I got another piece of the blue crayon. I'm just gonna throw it in there and stir it until I get the pigment that I like. As you can see already, it's kind of turning more of a darker blue. Now that that's done melting completely, I'm gonna turn off the stove and let it sit for about a couple of minutes so that it's not gonna melt the wick when we pour it into the mason jars. The wax is still a little too hot to pour into the jar, but I think I'm gonna do it anyways because I literally can't wait. I spilt it again. I'm just gonna put in a few drops of the scent into the candle. So for the third candle, I'm just gonna break up the remaining wax of this like I did for the other two, put them in the bowl, throw them in the pot so they can boil, add the fragrance, add the colors, and let them sit so they can harden. And then I'll show you guys the end result. So far I have a pink one and a blue one. I kind of want to do a lavender one and then maybe put lavender essential oils in this next one. I feel like that'd be really pretty. There's these two purples. I kind of want to do the wisteria one. I wonder if you can put glitter inside of candles because I feel like that'd be really pretty. Other than just like kind of decorating the outside of the jar. I'm just gonna cut the little bit of the tip off of it and throw it in there as the wax is melting. I'm gonna throw in a little bit more of that purple color because it's not giving me the pigment that I'd like. And I think it's because I used white crayon in the last one. So it's kind of counteracting the pigment. So for Christmas, my mom bought me essential oils with a diffuser, and I think you can use essential oils inside of like wax and stuff. I'm gonna use lavender. I'm actually gonna put some inside of the cup because I don't want my pans to smell like this. Just pour a little bit of that inside of there, and then I'm gonna also pour some inside after I dump the wax in there. So now that the wax is done boiling, I'm just gonna put that aside and actually let it set for the next couple of minutes. For these two, I didn't let the wax sit for a second so it could cool down. And that caused the wick to kind of melt and like fall over the plate. So I'm gonna let it sit over there for a minute and continue to clean up the mess that I made because it's a big one. I think we're ready for the pour. So I just finished cleaning up. I poured them all. The purple one is looking a little funky with all that mess going on, but the other two look pretty good so far. I'm excited to see when they burn, if they smell good or not, but we'll check back in when they're finished setting. All right, see you guys then. All I wanna do is give a big shout out to the people who make DIYs on YouTube or at home for fun. They're really like, one, time consuming, two, hard, because if you fail, then you kind of get upset. And then three, you just have a huge ass mess to clean up after.
So here's the final look of the candles. I think they look super good, super cute. I think they'd be fun to make and give as a gift, or just fun to make and have for yourself at home. So if you like this video, make sure you give it a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.